On the 27th of June, 1746, a small boat set sail from Benbecula to the west coast of Scotland, with destination the Isle of Skye. On board were six mariners, two servants, a woman named Flora MacDonald, and the Jacobite pretender to the English throne, Bonnie Prince Charlie. The prince was not so well disguised as MacDonald's Irish maid, Betty Burke. But why was Prince Charlie disguised? And what was she, Flora MacDonald, of the pro-government MacDonald clan, doing with this rebel? On the 19th of August, 1745, Charles Edward Stuart, also known as Bonnie Prince Charlie, began a rebellion in Scotland to win the British throne for his father, James Francis Edward Stuart. He was the son of King James II of England and the 7th of Scotland. This rebellion was part of the Jacobite uprising to bring back the Stuart family to the British throne instead of the reigning Hanover family. The last of a long series of rebellions, Prince Charlie's uprising began in Scotland during the War of Austrian Succession, while the British army was occupied elsewhere in Europe. On April 16, 1746, occurred the last battle of the rebellion, the Battle of Culloden. It lasted 1 hour and was a conclusive victory for the forces of the British government. Bonnie Prince Charlie was forced to escape. The British government offered a £30,000 reward for those who could capture the prince. The prince roamed the Scottish moors for 2 months, aided by Highlanders and supporters, until he arrived at the island of South Uist. There, one of his cohorts, Captain O'Neill, asked his relative, Flora MacDonald, to help the young claimant. Flora, however, hesitated. Her fiancé was a soldier in the government army, and her stepfather commanded the pro-government troops on the island. After due contemplation, she accepted to help, undaunted, and made the preparations for the voyage. Following the sea crossing in Skye, the group was hidden in a common cottage by the prince's partisans. The trip enabled the prince to get back to safety in France. In Skye, the prince allegedly bequeathed his savior a locket containing his portrait. Upon her return to South Uist, news of Flora's escapade with the prince had been broken. Flora was arrested and subsequently held in the Tower of London until 1747. So, what made Flora save the prince? Was it a need for adventure, or just a wish to help? It is unsure. In the declaration she made in July 12, 1746, following her arrest, she stated no one had persuaded her to undertake the voyage, and it seems she did so following her own choice. What is known, however, is that the pair never met again, and Flora herself hardly mentioned the story. Despite her reserve, Flora became a Jacobite heroine, known for saving their leader, who became a Scottish hero too. Following her release from the Tower of London, the Scottish painter Alan Ramsay painted a portrait of Flora, depicting her with a white rose, the symbol of the Jacobite rebellion. The story of Flora was immortalized on her memorial at Kilmore by the writer Samuel Johnson. It states, Flora MacDonald, preserver of Prince Charles Edward Stuart. Throughout the centuries following the story, and especially with the rise of the Romantic movement in the 19th century, many romanticized accounts of Flora's story were published. Songs were written, dances in her name were composed, and a statue in her memory was erected in Inverness Castle. Flora's story is one of strength and courage. It shows how someone who was not necessarily affiliated with the Jacobite movement became one of its most emblematic figures because of her actions in its direst time of need.